Hello everyone. Recently I shared via WhatsApp and my social media accounts a set of sentences, and I asked my friends and students to analyze those sentences and decide whether they are acceptable in English or not. And that set generated a lot of interest, and many of my teacher friends asked me to explain those sentences. So let me take this opportunity and say something. First of all these sentences are acceptable in English. It may be a surprise for some, it may be a shock for some people, but that's the fact. And many of these sentences are actually dictionary entries with a few changes here and there. So let me explain them one by one. The first sentence has two interesting parts. One is, some friends asked me whether it is in the team or on the team. So both these expressions are possible. You may be in a particular team or you may be on a particular team. In is more for British English and on for an American, for American English. Number two has the word, in the first sentence, to give 100% is an expression, it's a fixed expression, give 100%. The second sentence has won't without an apostrophe. So it is not the short form of will not. Won't itself is a word. And when you do something if that is your habit, something that you do very often, for that you can use the word won't. Somebody does something as his or her won't. So he's wont to yawn in mid-conversation, means that he does very often. If you live in the country, a car is a must. So here are two things. One, in the country, that means in a rural area, in a village kind of setting. And a must means something which is very important. So a must here is a noun form. Then fourth, I'm happy living in Surat. That's a perfectly acceptable sentence. I'm happy doing something. That's the phrase. I'm happy doing something. I'm happy living in Surat. The fifth is, the first person on my list is Sheila. Now again, in and on, they both are used for the word list. Six, that was a most interesting lecture. This is a special use of most. It means very. And it doesn't have the before it in this case. Then he was tortured for days on end. So on end, for days on end or for months on end, that's an acceptable expression in English. Number eight, many sleep on the streets in all weathers. Now normally we use weather as a non-count noun, but in this particular expression, in all weathers, the word weather is in the plural form. You can also use it as an uncount noun here. So in all weather and in all weathers, they both are possible. So I hope this video helps you in some way. And I would also like to show you on the screen some of the expressions. You can see here, you can see on the screen the sentences that I gave. Everyone on the team gave 100%. So here there are two interesting things. For the word team, suppose I write team, then my dictionary tells me whether in a team is possible or not, or on a team is possible or not. So in British English you can see in a team, and in American on a team. Both are possible. Then the second sentence says the word won't. So won't without an apostrophe is used like this, as is somebody's won't, means as is somebody's habit. So when you want to describe somebody's habitual action, you can use this. It's old-fashioned, but I have seen and I have read it very often. The next is in the country. I'm sure you know country songs and countrysides. It's a very common expression. So when you say the country, that means you are talking about rural areas. So in the country, the countryside. I've always wanted to live in the country. Then we have a must. Now here a must means something which is very interesting or exciting or useful. So here must is actually used as a noun, right? Then we have an expression happy doing something. Let's take another dictionary for a change. You can use Oxford, Cambridge, Longman, Macmillan. They're all famous ones, Collins. So, okay, the word happy is already there. You can see that. So, happy doing something. That is a phrase, happy doing something, right? Then we have the word list. So, we want to see whether the word list has in or on or both of them. Let's see here. You can see on a list and in a list, both are possible. Then the next one is a most interesting lecture. So here the word most is used as an adverb. And then when it is used as an adverb, it means very. Right? The word most as an adverb. Yeah. That means very. For example, here you can see, thank you for a most interesting evening. So here most can be replaced by very interesting evening. Then the next is for days on end, for months on end. That's a very nice expression, on end. You might have read or heard this, for days on end, without any stoppage. Non-stop, days on end. And the last word is the word weather, but here it is used in the plural form, in all weathers, like that. So in all weathers, that means in all types of weather. So this is a special use of the word weather. Normally we use the word weather as a non-count noun, but here it is used as a count noun. And if you see the first sentence, in the first sentence there was another interesting expression which many people found a little difficult. So give 100%. Suppose you start a project, then somebody might say give 100%. Some people might say give 110%. That means do everything you can in order to achieve something. So these are some very interesting items I would like you to pay attention to, and I hope you enjoyed this. If you want more information, please visit our website www.fluentlingua.com. Thank you very much. I'm Dharmendra Sheth from Surat.